Professor Dave again, let's learn trig identities.
He knows a lot about all kinds of stuff, Professor Dave explains.
We now know about the 6 trigonometric functions, so let's learn about some of the identities that apply to these functions. First, let's list the functions themselves. We have sine, cosine, tangent, cosecant, secant, and cotangent. We should recall that these 3 are reciprocals of the other 3, so we can express these as reciprocals of the others, or vice versa. Another identity we should be aware of is that tangent is equal to sine over cosine. This is true because if sine is opposite over hypotenuse and cosine is adjacent over hypotenuse, then the hypotenuses cancel and we are left with opposite over adjacent, which is the definition of tangent. Likewise, since cotangent is the reciprocal of tangent, that means that cotangent equals cosine over sine. There is another identity we must know, the Pythagorean identity. To derive this, let's start with the Pythagorean theorem that we already know. Now let's divide both sides by c squared. A squared over c squared is the same thing as a over c quantity squared, since exponents distribute over products and quotients. So we can rewrite this like this. From here, we can rationalize that a over c is the same as sine theta, because sine is opposite over hypotenuse. Similarly, b over c equals cosine theta, so we can rewrite this as sine theta squared plus cosine theta squared equals 1. When we raise a trig function to an exponent so that we don't risk ambiguity as to whether the exponent is operating on the term that the function is operating on, or if the exponent is operating on the whole function, sine theta quantity squared can be written as sine squared theta, with the exponent right here. This identity will be used a lot, so it's worth memorizing. We can also use this to derive other useful identities. If we divide everything by cosine squared theta, this term becomes tangent squared. This term becomes 1. And this term becomes 1 over cosine squared, or secant squared. If instead we were to divide by sine squared theta, we get 1 plus cotangent squared equals cosecant squared. So these are the 3 Pythagorean identities. Next, we want to understand the cofunction identities. Let's go back to the unit circle. Looking at the first quadrant, we see that the same values are used for the x and y coordinates, just in reverse order. In other words, the sine of 0 is the cosine of 90. The sine of 30 is the cosine of 60. This continues all the way through the quadrant. For this reason, we can say that sine of theta is equal to the cosine of 90 minus theta. For example, the sine of 30 is 1/2, and that's also equal to the cosine of 90 minus 30, or the cosine of 60. So this is a relationship that occurs between any pair of complementary angles. Likewise, the cosine of theta is equal to the sine of 90 minus theta. And because of these identities, we can also write similar ones relating tangent and cotangent, as well as secant and cosecant. Let's just quickly list the basic identities we have highlighted in this clip for ease of memorization. Once you've properly absorbed these, let's check comprehension. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. support me on Patreon so I can keep making content, and as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.